Okay, so enzyme activity. How do we tell if enzymes are working correctly in the body? Well, we can measure this just by looking at the amount of substrate and the amount of product. If the level of product is lower than expected, that would be an indication that the enzyme perhaps is not working properly. So what are some things that can influence enzyme activity? Well, certainly there are genetic considerations. If there's a gene mutation in the gene for the enzyme, then that could certainly modify enzyme activity. But ignoring that possibility, so let's just say we have an enzyme that is coded correctly, it has formed correctly in the body. What are some things then that can alter enzyme activity? We've got a list of them here. The two most common ones are up at the top. So temperature, if you change the temperature of the system, then that's going to modify the three-dimensional shape of the enzyme. If we change the pH, okay, so how acidic the conditions are, that can also modify the three-dimensional shape of the enzyme, right? If you add extra protons into the system, that's a charge, essentially. And if you bring that close to an enzyme, it's going to sort of push things around, change the way that amino acids are interacting with the system. So changing the three-dimensional shape, that's going to modify the active site and in turn the enzyme's activity. So coming over to these graphs here, in the human body, if we look at sort of the temperature map as it correlates with enzyme activity, okay, the human body tends to have a temperature right around in this area that corresponds nicely with the peak of enzyme activity. And this all ties back in with thermoregulation and homeostasis, right? So if our temperature starts to drop too low or if it starts to get too high, either way, the brain is going to detect that and initiate things to bring the temperature back into the normal range. If it didn't do that, then our enzymes would stop functioning properly. Coming on over to this graph, looking at pH, there are different locations in our bodies. Different locations in our bodies have different pH levels. And the interesting thing is that at each of those locations, the enzymes that are present there are optimized for those pH values. So for example, pepsin, this is an enzyme that exists in the stomach. It helps us with digesting protein, and its optimal pH is a pH of 2. That's the pH in the stomach. Okay, so this enzyme works very well in the stomach where it is located at. In the mouth is where salivary amylase is at. This is important for the initial breakdown of certain carbohydrates. In the mouth, things are not nearly as acidic. Okay, so again, fits with the organ that it has to function in. And then trypsin also, we'll be coming back to this one when we talk about digestion, the digestive system later on in the course. But each of these, interestingly, each of them works very well at the pH that they are located in the human body. Some other things that can influence enzyme activity would be concentration. So how concentrated are cofactors and coenzymes? We'll be coming to these on the very next slide, so hold that thought for right now. And then there are also some things that can be done to sort of modulate enzyme activity, and we will come to that one as well in just a few minutes. So let's go ahead and take a look at cofactors and coenzymes. What are these? Cofactors are ions. They're metallic ions that we have in our bodies. And what they do is they help to form the active site of the enzyme. If we take a look at this schematic of an enzyme right here, this enzyme has active sites up here at the top, and perhaps right now the affinity for the substrates is not all that great. Maybe this enzyme doesn't really, maybe sometimes it binds to the substrates, but it doesn't always consistently bind to the substrates. What can happen is a cofactor, one of these metal ions, what it can do is bind to the enzyme, and that will help to cause a little bit of a shape change, which makes the active site have more affinity for the substrates. So with the cofactor in place, now this enzyme binds very well to its substrates. So this cofactor is facilitating the enzyme doing its job. Cofactors can either bind at some location other than the active site, or they can actually bind like within the active site itself. Either way is possible. Those are cofactors. Coenzymes, on the other hand, this is something that doesn't go with the picture, so just ignore the picture for a moment. What is a coenzyme? A coenzyme is an organic molecule. A lot of times it's made from vitamins. This is one of the reasons that we need vitamins in our diets. And what they do is they act kind of like shuttle molecules. We'll be seeing the coenzymes quite a bit in an upcoming chapter. Coenzymes particularly are good at transporting hydrogen atoms and electrons as well. And they just sort of act like shuttles. They carry those hydrogen atoms and electrons from one small molecule to another. A lot of times they need to carry it to or from an enzyme. So we'll be coming back to that a little bit later on. Without the coenzymes doing their job, the enzymes might tend to get sort of clogged and just not be able to keep up with the work that they need to do.